Okay, so you probably just got done grouping a few objects or duplicating a few objects, and that's good. I'm glad you got a feel for it. So the next thing I want you to do is this. We need to go back to what's called the dashboard. It's that first screen we saw that had that button that said create new design. Now, some of you may also be worried about how do you save this. The nice thing about Tinkercad is that it saves sort of as you work. Like Photoshop, where you had to press Control S. With Tinkercad, you don't have to freak out. Just when you're done, yes, you can just close the window. But instead, like I said, we're going back to the dashboard. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come up here where it says Tinkercad, and I want to click right there. And if I click, you'll see that we're going back to the dashboard. Yes, I'm still using the Peter Parker profile. But, and I'm going to show you why that's important in another video coming up. But here's what we're going to do. Go ahead and create a new design. When we create our new design, this is actually going to be your first real project from me inside Tinkercad. And it's going to seem very, very familiar. And before you grumble and moan, you'll see what it is. Up here at the top, remember, I have to change my name. I'm going to click one time and I'm going to change it to this. But yes, we are going to make a hamburger in Tinkercad. And like in Photoshop, the very first thing we have to do is to create a bun. So there are two ways you can do this. First way I'm going to do it is I'm going to use the sphere. Just bring it out. I do believe there's like a half sphere down here. You can technically do that and flip it over. But there's a reason why I want to use just the regular sphere first. So get this, don't get this. And once you have your sphere, you might want to turn it up a few more steps just to smooth it out a little bit more. But when you have it, I want you squish it. Heck, I'm even going to hold shift and make it a little bigger. But you're going to have this shape. Now, I don't know about you, but my hamburger buns are not blue. So I'm going to find a color that looks like red. A weak guy. Go to custom. Right. I think that's a decent size. And the reason why I have you pulling out a sphere is because I want you to practice creating new shapes out of other shapes. So once you have your sphere, go back in your basic shape and pull out the box. But you need not the regular red box, you need the box that's set up as a whole. Now, when you have that, we're going to take this and we're going to put it in place. We've got to make sure that it covers the entire shape because if I miss this little bit, because what we're trying to do is to create the bottom half of the bun, we're going to cut the top half off. But we need to make sure it covers the whole thing. I'm going to show you what happens if you forget to cover the whole thing first. I'm gonna go ahead and that looks like everything. So as you can see, we have to definitely make sure all sides are covered. But if you forget and you raise this up, and maybe I want to go to the front view. Remember this orthographic view I talked about earlier? If I click on it will flatten it so we can see it better. As we can see, that almost looks right. I'll put perspective back on. Now, if I go ahead and I group this by selecting both objects and pressing Control G, watch what happens because I wasn't careful. What happens is I have a portion of my object create like a lip. Now, if this was your intention, that's fine, but I doubt it because again, bun should be cut all the way. Why am I getting this bad miscut bread from anyone with this one back? complaint management. So I'm going to ungroup by selecting my object and pressing Control Shift G, or I can always come up here. It even shows you the shortcut when you hover over. I'm going to ungroup. And from there, I will take my home. And if you had a problem, like you notice I couldn't see it or wasn't on the object, it's because both objects are selected. I clicked off and selected the hole itself. And I moved it. I'm going to move it out. So it looks like my hole is over the bread. I'm going to select both and press Control G. Boom, there's my bun. And what comes after the bun? By the meat patty. So I'm going to go in, pick a brown color, or I can choose the presets for a grilled color. Actually, I'm going to go lighter. The only reason why I'm going lighter is because I want to show that it is grilled. I'm going to add more sides though, but I'm also going to add a slight bevel and segments. So my bun does not look like a hockey puck like it's doing right now. Doesn't look too bad. I'm not happy with it, but it's not too bad. One thing I will do, remember how we make grill marks? Grill marks are going to be a little bit different here. To make our grill marks, cheat. And I say that we can technically use the round roof because we need this top curvature part. We could use a cylinder. Well, let's use another cylinder. We need a skinny cylinder. Go paint this black for a reason. And I'm going to take my skinny cylinder and I'm going to rotate. Don't panic if when you try to rotate this, it rotates in the wrong direction. As it's like parallel with your burger, you'll be good. We want to create grill marks. Actually, do two things. The first thing we have to do is we're going to cut out little divots in our patty. Once you have your cylinder, I'm going to copy and then paste it. And I'm going to click on the object. I'm going to press Control C. Go up here and copy it. Control V, click over here, to copy, second one to paste. I'm going to move my object over. One more time. V. Now, you notice I just selected all of my objects. How I did that is that I clicked on one, held down shift, and then clicked each of my four objects. And the reason I did that is this. I need eight more just like this, duplicated, or four more like this, duplicated, excuse me. So I'm going to group this first. And once it's grouped, I'm going to hold down the Alt key. I'm going to move this over. You're going to see why we're saving this. Because I take my group here and turn them into a hole. Once they're a hole, I'm going to take them and slide them down. Now, this 1 millimeter is just too much. So I'm going to come over here. Order 2.5. So I can bring it down halfway. And when I do, I'm gonna hold shift and click on my beef patty. I'm going to group it. I'm gonna press Control G, click on this button.